In lesson 5, we'll shift certain calculations to the Pi server. Certain simple calculations can be shifted from the analytics server to the data archive using the Pi Point data reference. These calculations include simple calculations such as average, total, maximums and minimums, and more. There are two advantages to performing these calculations on the data archive. The first is that the performance load on the analytics server is reduced. The second is that the network traffic between the data archive and the analytics server is reduced, as only the calculation result is sent over the network instead of the entire data set. It is worth noting that reducing the performance load on the analytics server comes at a cost of increasing the performance load on the data archive. However, the data archive is highly optimized for this kind of calculation and is often advantageous in terms of overall performance. If a Pi system collective is being used, the secondary member is often more lightly loaded, and forcing these calculations to take place on the secondary member can be helpful to data archive performance. Our first step is to compare results for an analytics calculation and Pi Point data reference summary calculation side by side. In Pi System Explorer, we'll navigate to the library, select our turbine element, and then the loss power 30-day average analytic. Notice that there are two variables here, one called analytics calc, using the tag average function, and the other which is called the server-side calc, which uses a loss power 30-day average server-side calc child attribute. So we'll preview the results by right-clicking and saying preview results. And notice that both the analytics calc and the server-side calc have the same value. So these two variables are performing the same calculation two different ways, one in the analytics server and the other inside the Pi data archive with just the result sent back to the calculation. Next, we want to modify this analytic to use the Pi Point data reference summary calculation rather than the tag average function. Notice that currently the loss power 30-day average variable is mapped to the tag average calculation. So we'll delete this, and then we'll click map and map this to loss power 30-day average. We'll check in our changes. And now this calculation will be performed on the Pi data archive rather than the analytics server.